We're lying.
It's mine. Thank you.
You're an American. Where are you from?
New York.
Yeah? Me too. How come I never saw you there?
I don't get out much.
My name's Jason.
Claire.
Nice to meet you.
Bye-bye.
You come here to dance?
I hope.
Jason, you sleep too much. I didn't get a wink all night. I couldn't get that stick of it out of my mind. I want it. You gotta get it, whatever it costs. Taxi! Did you see the stick of it in the catalog?
Yeah, the ones in white marble.
What? That's the Baldeo. The stick-em is made of bronze, patented black and gilt, rotating dials, and a rococo mythological figures. That's a stick-em. Come on, get in. What are you waiting for? Where's Monty Tam? A white marble stick-em? And I thought I heard everything.
Your tea, sir.
Good morning, Carl.
Good morning.
Everything is ready for the auditions?
Yes, sir. They're due to start in half an hour.
How many applicants do we have this year?
Oh, around 50.
That doesn't give us much to choose from.
This letter arrived from Vienna, the Theater am Wien.
What do they want?
Oh, they want to know if you would open their season with one of your ballets.
You know what to tell them, don't you?
Yes, sir. We could have had a chance to go and live somewhere real.
I've never had a fondness for your places.
Sarah West.
Pas de bourrée, renversée. Fouetté. Voilà, vous pouvez continuer. Les bras. Attention, les bras. Plus souple avec les bras. Attention, c'est un pas de val. C'est 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Soutenu. Posé. Pas de bourrée suivi. Attention aux talons. Les bras, je vous ai dit, plus souples, plus féminines. Le regard, s'il vous plaît. Voilà. Et un. Et deux. Et trois.
Awful.
What did they say?
They didn't take me. They're terrible. They make you do impossible things. That woman says I'm not cut out to be a dancer.
Claire Hamilton. Claire Hamilton. Alicia Cameron.
Nathalie.
A complete set? Are you sure of that? Uh-huh. Well, I'll have to think about it. You know, there are a lot of ballets around these days. Anyhow, I'll get back to you, okay? Now, wait a minute, I didn't hear what you said. Say
yes, again. Marty. I did the audition. Quite well. No, they haven't said if they're going to accept me, but they want me to come back in a few days. Yeah. Okay, so give Dad my love, huh? Bye.
Thank you.
15 minutes. What are you talking about? It's 3 o'clock in the morning.
Are you crazy? It's 9:45.
What?
Everything will be snapped up before we even get there.
Okay, I'll be right down. Goddamn clocks.
Oh my God. There's the old countess. It's a nightmare. She follows me everywhere I go. Vienna, Prague, Budapest. Wherever I am, she leaps out of the woodwork. She knows nothing about clocks, just follows my lead. She knows I'm a cunning old fox. If I raise a single finger, she snaps up the whole lot. All right. Okay. You just have to fool her. What if the bids come from someone else?
Like who?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It is our pleasure today to offer at auction an important stock of antiquities from the Goldberger collection. Each item will go to the highest bidder according to the terms and conditions of sale set out in your catalogs. We begin with lot number one, a late 18th century Austrian Grand Sonnery mantel clock with an enamel dial and central calendar hand, a three-train movement with anchor escapement and striking on two bells, flanked by statuettes of Poseidon, whose trident is missing, and the siren lacking a forearm. Now, who will start the bidding at 15,000 forints, 15,000, 20,000? Any advance of 20,000? Do I see 20? Yes, 25,000, 30,000? Yes, 35,000, 40,000, 45,000, 50,000? Any advance on 50,000? 55,000. It's 55,000 forints. It's going for 55,000 forints. Going, gone. Sold for 55,000 forints to the gentleman in the check jacket. The next lot, number two, is a magnificent Second Empire bronze table clock in the form of the terrestrial globe resting on the shoulders of Atlas. The hours are represented in inlaid enamel, and the orb is decorated with neo-baroque motifs. It has a cylindrical movement, and it strikes every hour. Now, shall we start the bidding for this superb piece at 30,000 forints? 30,000? Yes, 30,000? 35,000? 40,000? Yes, 45,000? Any advance on 45,000? 50,000? Any advance on 50? 55,000. Do I see 60,000?
60,000.
There has already been a bid for 60,000, sir.
I meant 70,000.
Oh, we are at 70,000 forints, ladies and gentlemen. Am I offered any more? 80,000? 90,000?
Where are you going? 100,000.
200,000.
The bidding is at 200,000 forints, ladies and gentlemen. It's going for 200,000 forints. Going. Gone.
It's not true ballerinas are always on a diet?
Actually, it is. But today is an exception.
How come?
Because today, I'm angry.
Oh. Maybe I should leave you alone.
No, don't leave. Where are you going?
Nowhere special.
Would you mind staying here with me? I'd like to have someone to talk to.
Yeah, sure.
what came over me. I'd spent months preparing for the audition. And then, when they called my name, I couldn't move. It was like my legs were paralyzed.
Exactly the same thing happened to me once when I was at college.
Really?
My first exam, I knew all this stuff. I'd been working on it night and day.
And then how did it end up?
Never even started. It was my last day at school, and I got a job.
Maybe that's what I should do. Maybe I'm just not cut out to be a ballerina.
Aren't you gonna give it another shot?
I don't know.
Come on, you got to. You come all this way, all the way from America for this. Look, if you want, I'll go back there with you tomorrow.
I'd like to have a second chance. But I also feel like leaving. Ready!
Claire. Look at this one. Statue by the 18th century sculptor Laios Neumann, depicting the myth of Daphne and Apollo. Daphne, a mountain nymph, was the unwilling object of Apollo's amorous intentions. She fled from him, but he pursued her and was about to catch up with her. She cried out for help to her mother, who changed her into a laurel tree, from whose leaves Apollo made a wreath to console himself. Hey, Claire, what are you doing in
Jason,
here?
Jason, come here. Look at this house. Isn't that pretty? I wonder if you still live here.
Guy doesn't mention it.
Let's see if we can get in.
Hey, wait a minute. Maybe somebody still lives there.
No, look. It's all abandoned.
These locked.
Well, there's another way in. Here, there's another door.
Claire, there's no way we can get in this place.
Look what I found.
How'd you know there was a key there?
We'll do the same thing at home.
Dickerman. My uncle saw this, he'd go out of his mind.
This house. I could live here.
I couldn't. Claire, I guess you must have lived here. No wonder you felt at home.
A ballerina who loved Swan Lake.
I want you to check all the backdrops.
Very well, sir.
The balls are coming up here.
I'll get them fixed.
We must replace the footlights. The curtain is too sluggish. I want it all working again.
What about the school, sir?
Tell Madame to suspend all classes. We're closing it up.
Every ballerina dreams of dancing Swan Lake. There are two parts, the white swan and the black swan, good and evil.
So, which one is the prince in love with?
The white swan.
How come he falls in love with a swan?
She isn't really a swan. Actually, she's a princess who's been turned into a swan by the spirit of evil.
Oh. Then who's the black swan?
Black swan. The black swan is another woman. But she's made to look exactly like the princess. But she's wicked.
Like you.
What do you mean? Honey, what makes you say I'm wicked?
Because you ate on my pie. Sorry. Can I ask you a very personal question?
I don't have a boyfriend. I guess my true love is really my dancing.
Yeah. I don't have a girlfriend either. I spend my whole life with clocks. They're not my true love. Well, this is my room.
Good night.
Where are you?
Down the hall.
I'll walk you to your door.
Are you still willing to come to the audition with me?
Yeah, sure. I'll meet you at 8 down in the lobby.
See you tomorrow, then.
Good night.
Jason? Welcome back, Natalie.
Can I help you?
Yes. Some flowers have been delivered to the wrong room. They're not for me. They're for someone called Natalie.
Flowers? I don't know what to say, Miss Hamilton. No one's been by since I came on duty.
But you have a guest called Natalie, don't you?
Oh, no, miss. There's no one here by that name.
Miss Hamilton come down yet?
Miss Hamilton has checked out, sir.
She checked out?
Just a short while ago, Mr. Forrest. She left this for you.
Forgive me, Jason, but I've decided to go home. Look me up when you get back to New York. Until then, Claire. When does this plane land in New York?
Arrival at Kennedy is scheduled for 2:30 local time. Gate bell. The plane will be aboard in 30 minutes. Enjoy your flight, Miss Hamilton.
Thank you.
There you are, Miss Hamilton. It comes to $82. Just sign here, please.
Thank you.
But it's a different name.
What do you mean a different name?
You signed Natalie Horvath.
Natalie Horvath is kindly requested to come to the information desk. Miss Natalie Horvath to information, please. Another call for Miss Natalie Horvath. She is urgently required to come to the information desk situated at the far end of the hall, where there is a message waiting for her. Miss Natalie Horvath is kindly requested to come to the information desk. Miss Natalie Horvath, to information, please. Miss Natalie Horvath is kindly requested to come to the information desk. Are you Natalie Horvath? Your car is ready.
My car?
Yes. The driver is waiting for you outside.
maestro is expecting you.
It's all exactly the same as it was then.
Are you American?
Sometimes.
Are you interested in that? It's a very rare piece. 18th century.
You're trying to tell me they had spring suspension in the 18th century?
Come to think of it, early 19th. Empire.
Second Empire.
Late 19th.
How much you want for it?
Well, as a matter of fact, it's not for sale. But just for you, shall we say, 80,000 florins?
If you can take off more than a century, you can also take off 30,000 florins.
30,000 florins? Impossible.
Dollars okay?
Dollars?
Let's see, in dollars that would be, Jason? Jason, where the hell are you?
Here, Uncle.
How much is 50,000 florins in dollars?
50,000?
Yeah.
That's $1,233.
Right.
1,300?
You take credit cards?
I prefer.
How about traveler's checks?
Of course.
I'll pay cash.
You've got a real bargain there, you know.
Uh-huh. And you got rid of a real piece of junk, you know?
Thank you.
clear. So you didn't leave after all. Where have you been? I haven't been able to stop thinking about you. Why didn't you call me?
I'm sorry. You must be mistaking me for someone else.
Claire, what are you saying?
I have to go now.
Hey! What's going on here? You gone crazy?
Let go of me.
Claire.
My name is Natalie.
Can I help you, sir?
Yes, I'd like to make an international call. New York City, please.
What number, sir?
It's area code 212-891-4265.
Booth number 2, sir.
Thanks. Hello.
Hi, this is Claire.
Claire! It's Jason.
I'm sorry no one's here to answer your call right now. If you leave a message, I'll get back to you as soon as I can.
I wanted to apologize for yesterday. Do you come here often?
Every day.
You like swans?
Yes. I like to watch them. Did you find that girl you were looking for?
No, not yet.
What's your name?
Jason. I'm staying at the Hotel Gellert.
Gellert.
Do you know it?
No. I don't think so. What are you doing here?
I don't really know.
My car is here. I have to go now.
Wait. Can't we just stay and talk a little longer?
I can't. I have a rehearsal.
What rehearsal?
I'm a prima ballerina.
Where are you dancing?
At the Brooklyn Tour Theater.
What's the ballet?
Swan Lake.
Free yourself from your body. I don't want to see any effort. You must fly. As free as the air. Now you are the white swan. In a while you will meet the prince. And as you dance, you are pleading with him. Save me. This is love you should be dancing. The pain of love. Now.
Good morning.
Good morning. I'd like a ticket for the first night of Swan Lake, please. Ticket for Swan Lake.
I don't think they're giving Swan Lake this year.
Sure they are. It's opening in a few days at the Brooklyn Tour Theater.
But the Brooklyn Tour is closed.
It's closed.
There hasn't been anything on there for years.
Thank you.
Good evening, miss.
Good evening. I'm looking for someone. His name is Jason.
Jason Forrest?
I think he's staying in this hotel.
Mr. Forrest is not in his room, but I just saw him a while ago. He must be around here somewhere. Just a moment. Mr. Forrest, there is a young lady in the lobby asking for you.
£15,000, 15,000, 20,000, do I see 20, yes, 25,000, 30,000, any advance on 30, yes, 35,000, 40,000, 45,000, 50,000, 60, 70, 80, will no one offer any more for this fine Wiedemeyer table book, yes, 90,000, 100,000, 110,000, going for 110,000 forints, ladies and gentlemen, going, done. Sold for 110,000 forints. And now we come to lot number 28. A portrait of a gentleman by an unknown artist of the Hungarian school, late 19th century. This painting, belonging to the Festetich family, formed part of their priceless collection at the Keszthely Castle on the shore of Lake Balaton. Now, the bidding for this painting starts at 40,000 forints. Yes, 40,000?
45,000.
What?
50,000,
60,000,
60,000,
70,000,
80,000. Well, the bidding is at 80,000, ladies and gentlemen. It's going for 80,000 forints. Going, gone. Sold for 80,000 forints to the gentleman in the check jacket. Now, we come to lot number 29. A bronze nude representing the biblical figure Susanna.
You belong on medication, you know that, don't you? This garbage isn't worth a cent. Why do you want it anyway? What the hell do you see in this crap?
Will you take it now, or would you like to have it sent?
I'll take it now.
You don't know nothing about the clocks. Despite the 3 years you've been with me, and now you want to branch off into paintings?
80,000 forints. That's over $1,500. 4 weeks' pay. Don't you forget that.
Bukentor Theater, November 1891, Swan Lake. Choreographer, Marius Blakem. Prima ballerina, Natalie Horvath. Natalie Horvath.
Mert mondtam, Katival mentem el.
Good evening.
Good evening.
I heard you were looking for company.
Well, actually, that is...
Perhaps I've got to the wrong room.
Oh, no. This is the right place. Please, come in.
Excuse me. You speak English?
Yes, I do.
Could you translate this for me, please?
Yesterday evening, at the Bruckenthaler Theater, prima ballerina Natalie Horvath was the victim of a tragic accident. Just before her entrance, she inexplicably fled from the theater and was knocked down and killed by a passing carriage. Do you want me to go on?
Yes, please.
Choreographer Marius Balakim, who had promised an unusual version of Swan Lake with a new ending, has cancelled all performances, refuses to see anyone or make any statement about the incident.
Is that all?
Yes.
Thank you.
So how did the story end?
I'm not sure it has an ending.
Jason, where the hell have you been? I've been looking for you all morning. I've packed your bags. We have to leave right now.
What are you talking about?
Your mother, she's in the hospital. Here, take this.
What's wrong?
She's been hurt. Leave that. I'll take the clock.
How is she? I mean, is it bad?
It's not good. We've got to hurry. There's a flight in an hour.
Wait a minute. I want to call home.
No time right now.
How'd you hear about it?
They sent a telegram.
What did it say?
I'll tell you later. To the airport. Hurry. Oh, just don't stand there like a dummy. She's not only your mother, she's my sister, too. Come on, get in.
Would you mind telling me what happened?
A car accident.
Car accident? She doesn't even drive.
A friend was driving.
Can I see the telegram?
I must have left it back in the hotel in all that confusion. And you, put your foot on the gas. I told you we're in a hurry.
Pull over. I want to make a call.
No, drive on.
I said pull over. I want to get out. Hello, Mom? Yeah, it's me, Jason. Yeah, I'm fine. How about you? Are you hurt bad? No? Ah, thank God. His Uncle Joshua told me you were in the hospital.
I told you not to call. Your mother's asking for you. She wants you. She wants you!
I just talked to her, and she said she's fine.
Your mother's dying. And she's calling for you. Can't you hear? Can't you hear? How callous can you be? You have to go. You gotta go right away. You're coming with me back to America. Jason! Jason! Come back here! Jason! 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 Jason, come back!
Somebody call for help! Get an ambulance here! Quickly!
Jason.
Don't try to talk. I'm gonna get you to a hospital right away.
Jason. Tonight.
What about tonight?
Swan Lake. I'm going to do it. Tonight.
What do you mean?
Thank you, Jack. Hey, Ed.
Open on that.
I don't understand. Hey, wait a minute. What do you want from me? Well, I told you I don't understand. Hey, where are you taking me? Wait a minute. I told you. God damn it!
Claire! Claire!
Claire.
I've been waiting for you. Thought you'd never come.
Oh, Claire. What happened to you?
I'm back. I was so lonely. I missed you terribly. Thought about you all the time.
Foreign tobacco. Keep the work light. Give me the night. Now the moon. Here I want a narrow beam of light for her.
When are we starting?
Dance is as ancient as mankind. I am memory. I remember. I see. I see into the darkness of time. Men with painted faces and naked bodies dancing in a circle. In the middle there is an effigy, the cruel image of the animal god awaiting his victim. I have been chosen. I am the one called upon to bring the ancient rite back to life. My Swan Lake will be different from all the others. Not the pretty fairy tale which ends with the triumph of good. I will put evil on the stage. And when all is finally accomplished, nothing will be left beyond the curtain except the void. Claire, listen to me. You mustn't dance. You've got to come away with me. This theater is damned. Come with me. It's dangerous for you here. You have to get away. Wake up, please. Speak to me. Say something, please.